wanted to share with you some of the things that I have been loving over the last several months, over the quarantine times. I honestly don't have a lot of makeup favorites because I haven't been wearing a ton of makeup. This is kind of the look I've been going for recently, which is super minimalistic, which is not usually my vibe. If I'm gonna wear makeup, most of the time I figure, why not go like full face, all out, eyeliner, all the things. But due to the current conditions, we went back to school this week and started our prepping for this year, and we're wearing masks all the time, and so you see this much of my face. So because of that, I've been wearing a lot of powder foundation. I've been wearing the Bare Minerals Blemish Rescue Skin Clearing Foundation. This one I got in an influencer. I don't love it, but it's what I have around, so I'm gonna work on using it up. It's fine, it serves its purpose, because I feel like if I put on a full face with foundation, I haven't been loving the way that full coverage foundation looks on my skin recently anyway. I feel like it's too cakey and heavy, but then it all just rubs off on my mask anyway, so it's not like it even matters. So I've been doing that. I've been doing a very minimal eye, which is kind of newer for me. My favorite thing to do has been to use my MAC shadows. I mentioned these in my 2019 favorites, I think, but I've been using a lot of this color, and I don't even remember what that color is, but it's just like a kind of shimmery champagne, and then soft brown, and then sometimes cranberry in the outer corner. I haven't been wearing a lot of liner, which is very, very rare for me. I usually wear full liner on the top and bottom and then blend it out. But I've been really liking to just tight line my top waterline and then blend out like my crease color into my lower lash line and then just wear mascara. And I've actually been really liking the way that that looks. It's a lot fresher. I feel like it's more fitting when I'm not wearing a full face of makeup. So that's been kind of like my go-to beauty routine. Other than that, I haven't been wearing a lot of makeup just because I don't feel like it's worth it when I'm wearing a mask all the time. So that's kind of where I'm at with that. I can't really think of any like major body care or like hair care products that I've absolutely been loving recently. It just kind of is what it is. But I do have some kind of like workout clothing favorites, some entertainment favorites, and some things that have kind of helped me keep sane in the last 6 months or so. I'm gonna start with clothing since that's like the first tangible thing I have here. I have talked a fair amount about Sunita, I think. So Sunita Athletics is an online workout brand that is one of my absolute favorite workout brands ever. I own a lot of their stuff. It's fairly inexpensive, it's really good quality. They have amazing customer service. I feel like if I have a problem, I can email them and they fix it almost immediately. I've had pairs of pants where the seams were starting to come loose within the first couple wears. I emailed them about it and they sent me a new pair, and they do an amazing job. It was a brand started by two sisters in Arizona. They put out swimwear recently this summer that I absolutely love. They just have a lot of really cute stuff. The only problem with them right now is that because they're a smaller company and because of the quarantine stuff, they sell out fairly quickly and they don't restock as fast as some people would like. A lot of their website is sold out a lot of the time, but I think that's not completely their fault. It's a supplier issue. But you can always put yourself on the wait list and they email when they restock, or if you follow their Sunita Sisters Facebook page, they let people know a lot when restocks are happening so that you can get in and try to get things. My workout clothes consist largely of Sunita at this point, and honestly, I wear Sunita all the time for just like regular everyday wear too. So they are an amazing brand, but I'm gonna share with you guys my top couple of favorites. I've said this in like probably 5 different videos that I was gonna film a full Sunita collection. I'm intimidated by it, but I'm gonna put it on my to-do list and I'm gonna do it sometime in the next couple weeks because I do think it's really valuable to see the things that they have and see kind of the favorites, the things that I don't think are worth it, because I own a lot of it and I think they are such an amazing brand. I've slowly converted a bunch of the ladies at my gym over to Sunita because it is just such good stuff. So one of my first favorites that I absolutely love, and I own this tank in every single color they have of it, I think. This is the Tahoe tank. And it is just like a racer back tank top. It's seamless, so it's got kind of like the folded over seams. And it is so thin and breathable. I absolutely adore these shirts. So these are two of the ones that I have. So this one's their Marsala one, which is more of like a rusty type color. And then, don't remember the color of this one, but it's like a purpley type color. These are amazingly thin and breathable, and they are some of the best I feel like for working out because they are cooler. I do have a problem with, they show a lot of sweat. So if you're sweaty at all, like your shirt is soaked and it's quite obvious in this particular material, but it also dries quicker than most materials. and I think they are some of the best. Plus, a lot of their stuff color coordinates, so you can like match with lots of their different collections, not just one. These tank tops, because they are so thin and soft, are absolutely amazing. One of my good friends loves them because the seams don't make her chafe when she runs, but I own every single color of these, I think. Next favorite that I have are the baseline shorts. So these are one pair of the baselines that I have. These are really nice because they have a couple pockets. They have like a key pocket up front that's in the waistband. Then they have two pockets, one on each side here. These are actually meant for tennis. So also on the other side of the short from the bottom, you could hold tennis balls in this from the bottom up. These are a 5-inch inseam and they do have like a higher rise waistline. I own these in almost every color. I think I'm only missing one out of their collection. So I have like a pink one, a gray one, a black one. These are their surf color. These are my favorite shorts because they do a really nice job of not riding up. They stay in place really well. And I feel like because of the pockets, they're really, really practical for lots of different uses. I use them for just like regular everyday wear. Sometimes I wear them for working out. They don't show sweat too badly. They're just my favorite of their shorts. And they are the ones that I wear the most often. I wear baseline shorts to my workouts most days of the week. I own their Rios, which are the 3.75 inch inseams, I think. And I do have issues with those riding up, but I don't have that issue with these. And these are the ones I feel the most comfortable in, that I feel like are a flattering length for my 5'2" frame. I adore the baselines. I think they are their best shorts by far. The last item that I'm going to talk about from Sunita for now are their Ava crop tops. So this one is their Marsala Ava crop top. So they're obviously cropped. They have a built-in bra, shelf bra with cups, and then they kind of have a crisscross strappy back. I wear these all the time underneath stuff. So like I actually am wearing it. It's my bra today. I wear it underneath t-shirts. I layer it under other things and it is perfect for layering. It comes in a ton of different colors. It comes in black and white and navy and the green, I think. Like there's a ton of colors that it comes in. My chest is a little bit smaller, so for me, I can wear it and run in it and it's enough support for that. It wouldn't be for everybody, but for me it is. And they mix and match so well with lots of different items from Sunita, and I absolutely adore them. I think they're a great staple piece because they are so comfortable and versatile to wear underneath other things and to layer. They're some of my favorites for casual, more casual wear. So that is it for Sunita. I will rave about them over and over again because they are so fantastic. They do such a nice job of kind of curating good collections that you can mix and match pieces with, and I adore them. The next couple of things that I'm going to mention are books. I have two tangible ones and one that's not. So the first thing that I have here is Love Teach, and it's Real Stories and Honest Advice to Keep Teachers from Crying Under Their Desks by Kelly Trelevian. This book is, I'm not all the way done with it yet, but I fell in love with it from the moment I started reading it. Love Teach is an amazing teaching blog that I have followed for years. And she is so funny, but she also talks about the topics that are really relevant to teachers. So she addresses it with humor, but she's also very honest about those things that people are gonna struggle with. And I really greatly appreciate her approach to it. This is the teaching book that I wish I had when I started teaching. I am starting my 10th year of teaching this year. And there are still things in there that she talks about that she wishes she would have learned earlier that I continue to struggle with as a teacher. There's things like just finding your people, finding your teaching best friend, the supplies that you should or shouldn't buy when you start school. She's just very honest and realistic and funny. I highly recommend this one. If you are a new teacher, you should read this. If you are a teacher who's been around for a while, you should read this. I think this is fantastic, and she is an amazing writer. If you don't follow her blog is also amazing. She talks about lots of teaching things that I think everybody can connect to if you are a teacher. The other one that I've really been enjoying, in a completely different take, is this is It Takes What It Takes, How to Think Neutrally and Gain Control of Your Life by Trevor Moad. This one I heard a podcast that he talked about, and it talks about the power that negative speak has. So when you speak negative thoughts out loud, that impacts you way more than speaking positive. But there's also the other side of it where there's the toxic positivity, that's not necessarily realistic. So looking at things in neutral terms is looking at things in a realistic way that can help you take steps to get where you're going to go. So it's looking at, what have I done in the past? What steps am I going to take to get here? Not just, I can do it. It's more of a realistic approach. He is a person who has worked with a lot of sports stars. So like Russell Wilson did the foreword. He makes a lot of sports references, which I'm not necessarily into, but you can still apply it to other pieces of your life. I have found myself much more often recently thinking more in neutral terms, and I am working on 75 hard phase one, which part of that challenge is that you visualize for 10 minutes a day. And in my visualization pieces, I feel like I'm much more aware of how I think neutrally and think, this is the step that I'm going to take next that's going to get me to here, rather than just saying, I'm going to meet this crazy goal. I think of things in terms of steps instead. So I highly recommend that one if you struggle with either like toxic positivity and being like unrealistically positive, or if you struggle with negative thinking. I think this is a great book. I really enjoyed it. It's a pretty quick read, honestly, and I think it's a good way to go about life and planning for goals and thinking about when you're stuck somewhere, what you're going to do to fix that. The last book that I have been really, really enjoying recently is The Four Tendencies by Gretchen Rubin. Gretchen Rubin does a ton of different books. She's done like The Happiness Project. She has a podcast called Happier with Her Sister. She's written a bunch of books, but The Four Tendencies I actually really, really like because I read a book by her that talked about habits. I can't remember the name of that book right now, but with that, she talked about how your tendencies are going to impact the habits that you build. So let's see, there's four tendencies that she talks about. So there is the obliger, which is me, which is that you can meet outer expectations that other people put on you, but you have a harder time meeting inner expectations. So that helps you know you need outer accountability to make better habits. So for example, I did 75 hard and I had an accountability partner as I did it, and that helped me be successful in that. Whereas if I just told myself I'm going to eat better, I probably wouldn't meet that expectation because I'm just telling myself that, and I have a harder time holding myself accountable. So having outer challenges for me is really important because it does make me achieve the things that I want to achieve. There's questioners who are willing to meet expectations if they know the reasoning behind those things. So my husband is 100% a questioner. So as long as he knows the good reason behind it, he's willing to do it. There's the rebel, the person who doesn't want to meet expectations unless it's something they really want to do. And then there's the upholder. So the upholder is somebody who is willing to meet outer and inner expectations. It doesn't really matter what they are, but it also means that they're much more likely to be inflexible about breaking those expectations or breaking rules or laws, because that's kind of how they are built. So I thought that was a really valuable thing to think about because it's helped me put into place things that will help me be more successful if I'm trying to meet certain goals. Knowing that about myself has unlocked a lot of things for me. So like 75 hard, I had posted on my Facebook that I was going to do it because if I knew if I had posted about it, that was going to hold me more accountable if other people knew I was going to do it, rather than if I just told myself I was going to do it and didn't say anything because I probably wouldn't meet that expectation if it was just me. So things like that have been valuable in understanding how my habits work and being more aware of that. I thought that was a pretty cool insight to figure out, but I've enjoyed a lot of her books. I think she has interesting insights. So yeah, those are the books that I've read recently that I've really enjoyed. I haven't really binge watched a whole lot of TV. I know a lot of people were like crazy over TV. I really haven't been engaged in it that much. The only thing that I've been binge watched since quarantine started was I watched 2 seasons of Grey's Anatomy and then I stopped. The only other show that I have binge watched, and it's a super random one, is Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman. It's the Superman show from the 90s that had Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher in it. I used to watch that when I was a kid, and for some reason recently I got the urge to watch it and I can't find it streaming anywhere, so I bought the series on iTunes because it was like $60 for the 4 seasons. And I love it. Honestly, Dean Cain is my favorite Superman ever. There's something so endearing about him as Superman and Clark Kent. Like, I adore him as Clark Kent. I don't know, like, if any of you guys are 90s kids that you recognize that show or you love that show, let me know, because I know it's not like super popular anymore. Obviously, it's not streaming anywhere, but he was my favorite Superman, and I just, it's so fun to watch the 90s, and a lot of the styles, it's kind of fun to watch it now and see the styles that are like back in style, some of the stuff that I would still wear today, and they're just so cute together as Lois and Clark. Like, I love it. I do. Anyway, that's kind of a random, silly one, but I really, really enjoyed it. Other entertainment things, I have two YouTubers that I started watching in the past few months that I really, really enjoy. There's Megan Batoon, who just randomly came on my, like, recommendations YouTube page, and I adore her. She's so honest and vulnerable when she shares her information, her life. She's so silly, but I don't feel like it's a scripted silly. Like, there's some people that you see their bloopers and you feel like they're not necessarily real, but I feel like she is just very her. She has a podcast that I really like listening to, and she does like lots of just really interesting content. So she does a lot of DIY projects, she does fashion videos, she just does lots of interesting things that I like the spread of her content, because I think it's very diverse and interesting, and it's not just cookie cutter like some of the things that you see. I also have really enjoyed Taylor Woods, who is both a YouTuber and she recently started a podcast, and I love both of those things. She is just so adorable. She does a lot of workout videos and she tries different workouts. She's doing 75 hard right now, so I thought that was really fun to kind of hear her journey on that, because I've done it and I do think it's really, really valuable. And just seeing, she's just so cute and like bubbly, and she's someone that I would want to be friends with in real life, I think. She just seems like a lot of fun, and her podcast is really enjoyable to listen to. I think she's very thoughtful. I've enjoyed those things. And then lastly, music favorites. My most listened to music recently has been Noah Cyrus, who is Miley Cyrus's little sister. Her voice is amazing, and she does the music that I wish Miley Cyrus would do. She does kind of the more indie type slower songs, and so her record that she put out recently, I absolutely adore. Her voice is just very soothing, and I really, really like it. Of course, the most basic of basic favorites, Taylor Swift's new Folklore album, I love. I know that everybody loves Taylor Swift, but with this album, I had texted my husband when I found out about it, and he was like, oh yeah, I'm sure that's gonna be great. Everyone's surprise album is always the best, but it actually is so good. Invisible String is my favorite. I absolutely adore the song Exile. I think that song is beautiful and their voices sound amazing together. It's with Bon Iver and it's amazing. There's something so soothing about that album. I didn't love all the songs on the first listen, but I've listened to it over and over again since, and it's really, really grown on me. All right, so that is it for my favorites. I know it's not a lot of the typical type things, but those are the things that I've been loving recently. I haven't been doing a lot of beauty stuff recently, but I have been engaged in a lot of different entertainment formats, and those are the things that I have loved over the last few months that have kept me sane and kept me happy and kept me motivated when I might have otherwise struggled. So, I would love to hear if you guys have thoughts on any of the things that I mentioned. What have you been loving over this time? Are there any things that you would recommend? TV shows, books, movies, music, workout clothes, based on some of the things that I mentioned? I would love to hear those in the comments down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one.